This is lesson 3 of 10, and in this lesson, we're going to be talking all about setting up sequences in Premiere Pro. We have a couple different ways we can do that. So we can come up to File, New, Sequence, or I can come down here into our new item, New, Sequence, or I could drag media in here to create a sequence. Let's have a quick conversation about sequences. So I'm going to go to New Sequence here, or on the Mac here, Command N. This used to be the very first thing that opened up when you opened up either Final Cut or Premiere. Now, this can be very, very daunting to people who aren't familiar with different formats. You'll notice we have something here called ARRI, AV, CHD, Canon, XF, MPEG 2, Digital SLR, etc., etc. What do all these different things mean? Well, if you've ever opened up Photoshop and you've been asked to create a document, you have several different options there. Usually it's going to depend on how big you want it as far as sizing and the color space. Well, a lot of those are very, very similar to what we're talking about here. Most of these presets here, so you'll notice that these are actually sequence presets, are based upon different camera manufacturers and different camera formats. So for example, we have RED cameras here, and in RED, they have several different options here. So we have our 1080p, 2K, 4.5K, 5K, and HD 4K. In our digital SLR, we have 1080, 480, and 720. So for our purposes right now, I'm just going to click once on this DSLR 1080p 30. And if I look at the description here, it says, for editing most DSLR formats, like Canon EOS movies, recorded in 1920 by 1080 square pixels, 16 by 9 progressive, at 29 frames per second, 48 kilohertz. If we look down here, this is basically telling us the same exact thing here, but with specific specifications, where this is just the description. So we see that our frame size is actually going to be 1920 by 1080. Our frame rate is going to be 29.97. Our pixel aspect ratio is 1.0. And our fields are going to be none. Most people who are going to be doing HD work are probably going to be working in this specific sequence preset. However, what if you're working with old footage or even 4K footage? What do these numbers actually mean? This 1920 by 1080 is the actual measurements of pixels. So if I'm going to go ahead, I'm just going to open up Photoshop here. And I know that this is a Premiere tutorial, but this will make a little bit more sense once we see this. And we're going to take a look at what these different frame sizes mean. You've probably been to the store and seen 4K TVs, 1080p, 1080i, 720p, 720i, all these different TVs, and what exactly does that mean? So if I come up here and I'm just going to make a new item here, and we're going to make film video, notice we have HDTV 1080, and that's telling us that our pixels are going to be 1920 by 1080, and our resolution is always going to be 72 because that's what TVs display at. And that's what that looks like. If we had something in 720, the shape is going to look the same exact way as this rectangular shape, except it's going to be less pixels. So it's going to look the same as far as shape, but our actual measurements is going to be a lot less. So what exactly do I mean by that? So I'm going to go ahead and open up this DSLR 1080p 30 really quick. And I'm just going to call this under its sequence name 1080. And we're going to hit OK. Right now, I don't have anything in here. For our purposes right now, we want to make something in here. So I'm just going to go to New Item. And we're going to go down to Color Matte. And you can think of this as just a solid color. It's asking me the size and time base for this, so I'm just going to make sure it says 1920 by 1080, and we're going to pick a blue color here, and we're going to call this 1080. And I'm going to drop that right into my timeline. So this is 1920 by 1080. Let's make another one here, color matte, and this time we're going to type in the number 1280 by 720, and I'm going to hit Okay, and we're gonna make this one red, and we're gonna call this one 720. And before we do anything else, let's make one more, and we're gonna make a color matte of 640 by 80. And we'll hit OK. And I'm going to make this one green. And we're going to call this one 480. So right now, this is our 1080p screen. If I play this on an HD TV, it would look like this. It would take up the whole screen, and that's all we would see. If I have a 720 resolution in a 1080, and I'm dragging that on top of video layer one, here's what we have. I'm going to do the same thing with this 480 and drag it on top of this one. So we have video one, video two, and video three. Again, what I'm doing here is I just dragged one here, and then 720 and 480. What we're seeing here is the difference in resolution between those different items. So for example, if I went to make a new sequence, I'm in file, new sequence, and I made something here at 480, my frame size is only going to be this big. If I made something in 720, my frame size is only going to be this big. And if I made something in 1080, it's going to be this big. Well, why is that important? Well, if I have a piece of footage or like a photo that's only this big and I drop it into my scene, it's not going to fill my whole screen. How can I make a setting that's always going to work for me? Well, again, if you're working in 1080, you can pretty much just choose this one here. Otherwise, if we want to create our own, under settings here. And under settings, we can specify our own specific editing mode and sequence. You'll notice that we have a lot of different formats here. We don't care about any of these. What we're going to do is come right up to custom. And as soon as we're in custom, that lets us change everything we have here. We want to change our frames per second. If we're going to be doing anything in TV, we're probably going to be doing things at 2997. If you're outside of America, you may be working in 25 frames per second. For our purposes, we're just going to be working in either 29 or 30. We're going to leave that at 29. And we can specify our frame size. Notice that we have 1920 by 1080, and we've got this number here that says 16 by 9. What that number means is the ratio of these two numbers. So for example, if I change this to 1080 by 1080, our ratio would be 1:1. And if I created that, it would be a square. And I'll undo that here and we'll come back into our sequence. What that number means is that this number reduced to its lowest common denominator and this number reduced to its lowest common denominator would be 16 by 9. If we had something that was like this, 1280 by 720, you'll notice that it's also 16 by 9. That was done on purpose originally when HDTVs were coming out because the jump from standard resolution, which was 640 by 480, was in a 4/3. And to go from 640 to 480 to 1920 by 1080 was a lot of information. So as a way to kind of give people time to catch up technologically, a lot of companies just made 720. Now you can see that 1080 is much more resolution than 720, but it's the same shape. So it was a little bit more forgiving. You've probably heard the words standard definition and high definition before. Standard definition is anything that is 720 by 480 or lower. And anything that is higher than 720 by 480 is technically high definition. So this could be 721 by 481. And it would technically be HD. However, there's nothing really that could display that. We have certain specifications like 1280 by 720 that we can do with that. We can also change the ratio of the pixels. For our purposes, we're always going to leave this as 1. However, you may run into times where our footage is actually 1440 by 1080 and has a pixel aspect ratio of 1.333. What this means is the pixels aren't square like we established here when I changed this to 1080 by 1080 and made a perfect square, is that our pixels are actually stretched a little bit. So that way it's going to look the same as 1920 by 1080 footage, but these pixels have all been stretched by about 33%. So we just want to make sure that that is at 1920 by 1080. If you want some more information on these different aspect ratios, I definitely recommend checking it out. It's a lot of really useful information. However, most of the time you're not really going to run into any of that anymore. Since everything nowadays is square pixels, that's what you're going to be working with unless you have some old types of footage. The next one that we have here is our fields. What this means is either progressive scan or interlaced. If you don't know what that is, that's fine. Stick with progressive scan. More often than not, that's going to be what you want to work with. Under our audio here, we have different sample rates. 32,000 hertz or 32 kilohertz is about FM quality sound. 44.1 kilohertz is CD quality sound. 48 kilohertz is DAT or digital audio transport quality sound. HD and Blu-rays top out at 96 kilohertz. From the audio engineers I've spoken with, they say that typically no one can hear above about 52 kilohertz, so all this is a little bit of overkill. I typically stick with 44.1 unless it's something that is specifically audio driven, and then maybe I push it to 48. So that's just my personal preference. I might be wrong about that. I'm not an audio guy, I'm more of a video guy. So that's what I stick with. Again, our display format, we have our milliseconds and our audio samples. Again, we have 44,000 samples here per second. So I'm gonna wanna stick with audio samples. And the rest of this, I want us to ignore for right now. The one thing I do want to talk about right here is this save preset. And what this save preset is going to do is create a preset for us to just jump into as soon as we start Premiere Pro. So I'm going to call this one 1080p HD. And under the description, I'm just going to write, when in doubt, use this file for HD output at 29.97, 1920 by 1080. And I'll hit OK. Now, as soon as I've done that, you're going to notice at the very bottom of my sequence presets here, I'm going to have a custom. Under my custom here, I have a second one that I've already created, but I've got this one here that says editing mode custom, 1920 by 1080, 1.0 pixel aspect ratio, 29.97, no fields, 48 samples per second. And we'll go ahead and we can name our sequence HD sequence. Now what this is going to do is name our timeline. Notice now I have two different timelines. We can actually have multiple timelines in our Premiere Pro project. In fact, it's very common for me to have maybe 20 or 30 ones as I'm running through different revisions. So there you go. That is the way that you can create different sequences and set up your project in Premiere Pro. If you're looking for more information, you can always find more of my work at stanislawrobertliberta.com. I offer face-to-face training and classroom-based lessons in Premiere Pro, After Effects, Final Cut Pro, Motion, and a few other programs. In the next lesson for our Adobe Premiere Pro introductory class, we're going to be talking all about importing. Different files that you can import, things to be aware of, how to import different items and bring them into our timeline. My name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra, and hopefully you found this lesson useful. See you next time.